All right, guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video, we are going to talk about Antilag. Now, Antilag is something that I'm really excited about because I know from a performance standpoint, it gives us a huge advantage over, you know, the competition or anybody that doesn't have it. However, there are a lot of potential safety concerns and just risks that you should be aware of before you use it. So I'm going to use this video to tell you guys what it is and how it works. And then I'll also kind of go over the pros and cons so you can decide whether it's something that's worth it to you. So let's go ahead and hop into the video. So the reason why Antilag is so important for us is because our cars, of course, come with a turbo. And most of you know how turbos work, but just in case, the way it works is you have basically all of your exhaust gases coming out of the exhaust manifold and it goes into the turbo. And that air spins up the exhaust wheel before it goes out the rest of the downpipe. Now, that wheel is connected to a wheel on this compressor side, and that wheel spins at the same speed and creates a vacuum that sucks in air and forces it into the engine. So that's why this is called forced induction, because it's literally sucking in more air than the car could naturally take in, and it's forcing it into the engine to create more horsepower. Now, the downside that comes with this is you need that exhaust gas to come out at a really high velocity with a lot of airflow to spool up the turbo. So when you floor it, there's going to be a little bit of a delay because those gases have to start coming out to spin up the turbo and create that boost that gives you your peak acceleration. And the other thing to consider is as you add more power, you're going to add more lag. So let's say you're running 20 PSI, now the car is going to take longer to hit peak boost than it did when you were running 10 PSI. Or if you put on a bigger turbo like I did, it'll take you longer to hit 10 PSI on that bigger turbo than it would on a smaller turbo. So basically anything that you do to increase your horsepower is going to increase the amount of lag or delay that you'll see before your peak acceleration. So that lag is basically the enemy in what you're dealing with anytime you want to get the best performance out of your car. And that's where Antilag comes in. So normally, like I said, you're waiting for the exhaust gases to come out through the turbo, spin it up, and then go through the exhaust to create that boost pressure. With Antilag, it's basically adjusting your engine's ignition timing so that you can create that pressure without actually, you know, mashing the pedal and flooring it. So what's going to happen is when you hit that trigger to initiate Antilag, it's going to delay your ignition timing really significantly. Normally, your entire combustion process is going to happen with the whole chamber sealed up, and it's going to use all that energy to push the piston down. But instead, with Antilag tune, what it's going to do is delay the ignition so that the combustion process is still happening when the exhaust valves open up. So now you're going to have part of that combustion process happening with the exhaust valves open, and that's going to allow that combustion pressure to exit out the cylinder head through your exhaust, and it's going to spin up your turbo. So it won't give you additional power to actually help the car accelerate, but it will begin to spool up the turbo because you're going to see some of that combustion pressure in the manifold. So that's a really nice thing to have from a performance standpoint, because let's say, you know, you're doing a 40 roll, you're rolling at 40 miles an hour. Now, instead of having to floor it and wait for the turbo to build up, you can hit that anti-lag switch and it'll begin spooling up the turbo. So as soon as you're ready to go, all of that torque and horsepower is right there available and you'll just fly straight forward with full boost. This can also help if you're launching your car. So if you're able to use your anti-lag from a standstill, you can create boost. And then when you launch your car and take off from a stop, you'll have, again, all of that boost and torque available. As long as you have the grip to put it down, it'll help improve your 0-60 times and your quarter mile times. Even in road racing or, you know, around a course where you have turns, it can help out a lot, because when you come to a turn and you hit the brake, you're going to have to wait for that boost to build back up when you get back on the accelerator pedal. So there are instances where, you know, you're on the brake going into a turn, and when you're ready to come out, you can hit that anti-lag switch. So now your corner exit speed can be even faster because you'll have more torque and horsepower available when you accelerate out of the apex. And then one last smaller benefit that affects, you know, a lot less people, but if you're like me and you have a manual transmission and you're able to have your anti-lag going between shifts, that'll be a huge advantage, because if you have a manual transmission, one of the downsides is every time you shift, you have to come off of the throttle, and it's a lot safer to use something like anti-lag than just no lift shifting and power shifting to try to keep the car in its power band without losing boost. Now you're going to have the ECU controlling it to keep boost at its peak while you're going into your next shift, And then when you get back on the throttle, you'll have all of that torque and horsepower available to keep propelling you forward. So obviously, all of those are really good. Not all of them will be available with the tuning software as they, you know, come out for the B58, but we'll have to just continue testing it and trying it out to see what options are available to us. But there are a lot of downsides and potential safety concerns that you guys should be aware of. The easiest way I associate this is with burbles, because a lot of people know that aggressive burbles can damage things, and Antilag is kind of similar to burbles. So the same way that you think of what you should consider before running aggressive burbles is kind of your thought process that you should have before running Antilag. But just kind of consider that it's aggressive burbles taken up to the next level. The primary difference between Antilag and burbles is that with Antilag, you're actually setting like a boost and a load target with the engine. So you're basically trying to create the amount of load you need to create the exhaust gas flow and the exhaust velocity needed to spool up the turbo. Whereas with burbles, you know, all you're trying to do is get that additional sound. So obviously, you know, you guys see a lot of the videos with people having Antilag and it shoots flames out of the exhaust and it's really loud. And so first and foremost, make sure you have a catless downpipe. You should never run this with a catted downpipe, even if it's a high flow cat, because the Antilag can damage it. It can potentially cause you, you know, to melt it. You can blow it out, you know, cause a big blockage in your exhaust and cause a lot of other issues. So only run it if you have a catless downpipe. Now, fortunate for us, the rest of our exhaust is pretty much straight through. Even like the resonators and stuff don't have any baffles. So that is less of a concern if you have like a stock mid pipe. But on the muffler end, if you have a valve, that is also a potential risk, because you can damage that valve from running Antilag and having all of that extra pressure coming out through the exhaust. So I would say 100% you need a catless downpipe, and I would also recommend running, you know, an aftermarket muffler, or at least pinning your muffler valve open so that you don't blow it out and damage it. Another thing to consider is exactly what's happening with Antilag. So like I said, a lot of that exhaust pressure and the combustion process is happening with the exhaust valves open. Sometimes you're even igniting a little bit of fuel in the exhaust itself, like in your turbo manifold. And when that happens, you are significantly increasing your exhaust temperatures, you're increasing your exhaust pressures, and everything that typically you want to avoid from a tuning standpoint, because you know that excessive pressures and temperatures in your exhaust can damage your turbo. So just in the same fashion, running a lot of Antilag over and over and over will wear out your turbo faster. So just keep that in mind. You know, it's something that you can run from time to time, but you definitely don't want to run it all the time. You don't want to be that guy that's just revving and revving and making it go off at car meets and stuff. You can do it if you want to, but just be aware that it's going to accelerate the wear on your turbo and cause it to fail more prematurely. Now, luckily, our tuners have considered a lot of this, and so as the software comes out, you guys will see that a lot of safeties are in place. It'll have a lot of things like temperature thresholds, where your car has to be, you know, above a minimum temperature so that you're not doing it on a cold engine, but it also won't do it above a max temperature so that you're not letting the engine get too hot. There are also going to be time durations and delays where you have to wait for a certain period of time before activating it again. This is all just to protect you and your engine and your components. So this is at your benefit, you know. But of course, with a custom tune, if you want to take on more risk, you can dial those back, or you can even turn up the safeties if you want to, you know, give yourself a little more headroom when using it. But yeah, that's basically it as far as Antilag goes. Like I said, I do plan on using it myself. I won't use it all the time, but when I'm doing, you know, real coordinated races and lining up with people or at a track, I'm going to use it so that I can get the best performance possible. So use it at your own risk. Be aware of what you're signing up for. And as always, you know, enjoy responsibly. So thanks again for watching my videos. I hope this really helps you guys out. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do 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 do